Hello, I want to use this opportunity to welcome you to another exciting week, just to connect with you a little bit and let you know that it's been a great pleasure going through this journey with you. I don't take this lightly. I know whatever you're studying in this class has an impact on your life and the direction that you are going. So I take this very seriously, and I'm just using this opportunity for us to connect. I know it's an online class, and you it may get a little bit somehow impersonal, but know that I am always available. If you reach out to me, if you have any questions, any doubts, any difficulties, any concerns, I will appreciate if you can text me or email me or give me a phone call. You have my number. Don't feel that you are bugging me or you've overdone it. We are in this together, and I desire very strongly for you guys to have a good experience and to succeed as well. This week we're going to be looking at earthquakes. I know there was an earthquake in the news in LA, there is a lot of concern about the aftermath of earthquakes and the destruction that accompanies it. So you're going to be learning this week how scientists are able to understand what causes earthquakes and how to use the foreshocks and aftershocks to be able to figure out what is going on the different parts of the world where earthquakes are prone to occur. You know very well from our studying of the different plate boundaries that those that are active are also going to be earthquake prone as well. When you have volcanic activity, when magma is moving towards the surface of the earth, there is some resistance involved with it, and it's going to cause earthquakes. You're going to be, each time we talk of earthquakes, people talk about fracking and its relationship to earthquakes. And I just want to take this opportunity to say that, fracking does not cause earthquakes directly. What happens is that the wastewater from production of oil and gas, when it is injected in shallow disposal wells, if you have old faults in these areas, there is the possibility of some of these faults to be reactivated, and when that happens, you're going to have earthquakes. Remember again to make sure that you utilize the discussion board if you have doubts and concerns. Raise questions, raise the issues that you need to explain in there so that the whole class can benefit. Always do your utmost best to respond to at least one post by another student, and ask questions, use images, and elevate the level of the discussion. You have a fantastic week. Just hang in there. We're getting closer to wrapping up the course. There is still a lot of room for you guys to improve your grade. So far, so good. A lot of you are putting in a lot of effort and doing a great job. I just want to encourage you to keep it up. Let me know if you have any questions. Have a fantastic week. Thank you.